whoever flew the Tomcat has a lifetime of memories. And so it's about narrowing it down to, you know, what stays with you and what lives with you. For me, there's three memories that last a lifetime. Two of those are lifelong and one is just kind of recent, but they all sort of tie together. That first lifetime memory is walking up to the jet, doing the pre-flight. No matter what angle you approach that jet, the Tomcat just looks menacing. And it's a call out to you to be as good as the jet and as good as the jet looks. So I remember that the first time for my first hour, and almost a decade later for my last flight, 2,000 hours later, that feeling, walking up to the jet, looking at it, challenging you to be as good as you could be in the jet. That has lasted a lifetime and will never go away. The second is taking that jet and again following this mindset of being as good as you can be in the jet. It literally was a life experience going through the new Top Gun program. And that's what kind of, for me, filled the picture. So you jump into this jet and then you go through what was then a brand new Top Gun program, about their 25th year. And that essentially changed the dynamics across the flight line. And what that did was, and I was in the very first class. In fact, there were so few of us, we didn't have a full class. We still had folks kind of going through the old program, but this new program had teeth to it. And it was basically a challenge to you. You be as good as we want you to be, or quite frankly, we're gonna send you home. And in some cases that happened. Being in the first class, I had to make sure I didn't get sent home. It was a 9-week grueling course. The Tomcat was built for the Cold War days. It was strictly a fighter. That's why it was an F-14, not an FA-14. All the missions were air-to-air. It was basically, you know, defend the carriers from, you know, the hordes that were gonna come over the horizon. And when I started at the FRS, the Fleet Replacement Squadron at Miramar, we were the first class to take this old AUG 15 panel that literally was built for bombs but had never been used and get the wiring to work. And we were the first class to start dropping bombs. And that was the transition of, this is not only going to be a fighter, but it's going to be an attack aircraft too. So big F, little A. By the time I got into Top Gun through the SFTI program, it was now big F, big A. We had the Lantern pod, a lot of new systems, and this is where industry comes in to react to a jet that was built to be a fighter and integrated into a strike fighter. And that first class was pretty challenging. It wasn't just being the fighter guys going down range and cleaning everybody's clock in the air. It was do that and then follow on, get to the target and hit targets with precision and then fight your way out of there. And it's kind of the theme of the Top Gun Maverick movie. It really comes down to the person in the box. It's a pretty audacious threat going in. You know, you don't just drop your bombs and go away. It's hit your target with precision and then fight your way out. So the Super Hornet is depicted in that role in the Top Gun Maverick, but the F-14 and at that time the F-18, the Charlie, what we call the Legacy, both those aircraft are really, that's what those missions are. Be able to fight your way in day and night, put bombs on target on time, and then fight your way out. So prior to going through Top Gun, you felt lethal in the Tomcat, but you weren't quite sure if you were as good as you were ever gonna be. We go through this brand new Strike Fighter Tactics Instruction Program, being the first in the class, and that type of training in that jet, and I'll say it with conviction again, it didn't matter who you were fighting against or who was in that cockpit, you were gonna kill them. That has stayed with me for a lifetime. So that was, there were some non-believers out there. You had a lot of guys holding on to the fighter mission, but once we started proving ourselves in the attack realm, and again, that's thanks to all the coordination, you know, from NAVAIR, across naval aviation and the industry response to get us not just the FLIR system, but the smart bobs and all the other systems that come with that. I mean, that thing was lethal all the way to the end. And for those that say we never should have left the jet, I may have been one of those at the very end, but then you jumped into the F-18 Super Hornet and you know, right jet at the right time, and it continues to grow. And I think those that would say, you know, we don't want to go to the next generation, all I got to do is look at the F-35 and what that brings to the table, which we can't talk about publicly. But when you know what it can do, we're going in the right direction. The third memory is again kind of tying in this be good in the jet, show what it can do, and that's kind of the theme of the Top Gun Maverick movie. And I was privileged enough to be one of the Navy advisors early on in the movie, and I remember getting the first script, and I got towards the end, and lo and behold, they're resurrecting the Tomcat. So again, that's sort of a lifelong memory. So those three to me kind of culminate all the time, all the experience in a Tomcat that will last me for a lifetime.
Please like and share if you find the video content interesting. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and comment below so as not to miss new upcoming videos. And see the entire film now streaming, or order the Blu-ray and DVD online on our website, speedangelsproductions.com.